Today, tomorrow, Toyota. Though the company has been experiencing a renaissance as of now, where they intend to expand their product line with further fascinating automobiles basically in the EV market, Toyota has recently dropped the news that they'll be introducing a vehicle that is neither an SUV nor a crossover, and it has the entire electric vehicle market reeling. Interested to know more about it? And if this is better than the Ford Mustang? Also, we'll be talking about the Gazoo family. Want to know what it is? Well, continue watching Tech Addicts, as this is the planet only made for you and can answer your every question. So without any further ado, let's get into our video. The first electric amateur touring race car to be approved for competition in the NASA Super Touring Series was unveiled at SEMA by Canadian business Scalar Performance. The SCR1 takes its cues from the Toyota GR86, but it ditches the 2.0-liter engine in favor of an electric motor by Hypercraft and a chassis tuned for the racetrack. They wanted to provide a purist driving experience that requires minimum maintenance and allows the team to focus on course layout and driver development, as stated by Scalar Performance co-founder Brian Bourne. The SCR1 looks like a legitimate race car right off the bat, thanks to its stock Toyota GR86 body and a few specially made additions. Included in this list are a new diffuser that replaces the exhaust pipes, a large rear wing, tow straps, and a noticeable splitter. All new Inkle 18-inch alloy wheels with Hoosier Racing rubber equip the EV. The inside features an SFI safety racing net window, a Sparco racing seat with 6-point seat belts that have been authorized by the FIA, and a VR3 engineering 8-point roll cage. All-wheel drive, 328 horsepower, and enough power to race for 45 minutes. Hypercraft's single 800-volt electric motor delivers 328 horsepower and 345 pound-feet of torque, making it more potent than the standard internal combustion engine-powered Toyota GR86 and Subaru BRZ. A top speed of 165 miles per hour is possible with those specifications, and it can accelerate from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 3.9 seconds. It uses a Torsen limited-slip differential to send power to the back wheels. The 65 kilowatt-hour capacity of the motorsport-grade battery allows for almost 45 minutes of racing time between charges. When hooked up to a Level 3 DC fast charger at 150 kilowatts, a full charge can be achieved in less than 20 minutes. The battery pack contains a fire suppression system called Lifeline, which uses Novec 1230 fire protection fluid, and the race car itself has temperature management and runway prevention devices for safety. The SCR1's marketed as having a similar driving experience to that of a mid-engined internal combustion engine racer. The SCR1 weighs in at a hefty 3,040 pounds, which is 227 pounds more than the street-legal Toyota GR86. The SCR1 has 6-piston front calipers and 4-piston rear calipers, and the suspension was custom-tuned. During the dates of November 1st through 4th, 2022, the SCR1 will be on display at SEMA in Las Vegas. The electric racing car will be released to the public in a limited run of 10 founder editions in the summer of 2023. Owners will receive assistance from the engineering team, including over-the-air upgrades, and each car will have a numbered plaque and a roll cage painted to the owner's specifications. And the Toyota GR86 would take home the prize for most improved sports car, well, if we presented such an honor. The second edition of this fun-to-drive rear-wheel drive coupe debuted in 2022, fixing the major flaw we found in the first generation, a lackluster engine. The second-generation model is powered by a 228-horsepower flat-four engine that provides ample mid-range torque. A 6-speed manual transmission is standard, but an automatic is an option. We won't encourage you to go that route. The GR86 is little and reasonably priced, much like a Mazda MX-5 Miata, but it also features a rear seat similar to that of a Porsche 911, so you can bring along the kids. Furthermore, its hatchback body design provides useful baggage capacity, something the Miata lacks. Almost everything else about driving a GR86 or a Subaru BRZ, the latter of which is mechanically similar to the former, is the same, so your decision should come down to whose badge you like better. The GR86 is exciting to drive, but its road noise, especially on the highway, and boxer engine sound, are disappointing for a two-seater coupe. Due to its great cornering grip, balance, steering, and rev-happy engine, the GR86 is fun to drive anywhere. It offers everything a first-time sports car buyer needs. As of the year 2023, Toyota's made no changes to what we consider to be the best cheap sports car. An additional GR86 Special Edition model's been introduced. Solar Shift orange paint, a roaring cat-back performance exhaust with black chrome tips, and matte black 18-inch wheels are just a few of the unique features added to the GR86 Premium for the Special Edition. Pricing. The 2023 Toyota GR86 Premium is worth a small premium above the standard model. Heated seats, attractive 18-inch wheels with summer performance tires, adaptive LED headlights, and a more impressive 8-speaker audio system are all included in the Premium Standard Kit. Similarly, the 6-speed manual transmission should be considered. Motor and efficiency. The 2023 GR86, like the original, is powered by a Subaru-supplied, horizontally opposed 4-cylinder with natural aspiration. The previous generation 6.2-second sprint to 60 miles per hour was respectable, but the 5.4-second sprint and 14-second quarter-mile time produced by the most recent GR86 we tested made it the fastest production car we've ever tested. The upgraded performance comes from a 2.4-liter engine with 228 horsepower. The GR86 is available with either a 6-speed manual or an optional 6-speed automatic transmission. 7/10 of a second more time was needed for the 6-speed automatic to reach 60 miles per hour compared to the manual. While driving around the Monticello Motor Club race course for the first time, we noticed that the car's increased power and responsiveness made for an exciting experience. Although it has excellent handling, the car can be used as an everyday driver thanks to its forgiving suspension. So let's compare the GR86 with the Ford Mustang 2023. The Mustang outclasses the GR86 in every measurable dimension. Although the Mustang lacks the Toyota's agility and responsiveness due to its larger size, it more than makes up for it with its potent engine and relaxing interior. Since it's bigger overall, it can accommodate more people and has a larger trunk. Both the base model GR86 and the Mustang EcoBoost, which come with either a 6-speed manual or 10-speed automatic transmission, start at the same price. When compared to the Toyota, the Mustang offers more customization options, including the ability to pair the manual transmission with modern safety features. Here, we're going to talk about the Gazoo family quickly. Toyota has a long history of involvement in motorsports, spanning from Formula One to the World Endurance Championship to the Nürburgring 24 Hours Endurance Race. Toyota Racing, Lexus Racing, and Gazoo Racing were internal subsidiaries responsible for these tasks. Automakers utilize racing as a tool to test the limits of a vehicle's performance and strive for dominance, much like athletes use the Olympics to evaluate their abilities. This helps them find new ways to advance automotive technology. And in light of this, Toyota refocused its efforts in racing in April 2015 under the banner Toyota Gazoo Racing, establishing motorsports as a cornerstone of Toyota's dedication to developing ever-improved vehicles. So, who could ask for anything more? What are your thoughts on Toyota's GR86? Comment down below and let us know. And if you want to see more videos like this one on your homepage, please click on the notification bell and the like button before you leave. And thank you for watching.